What is going on, everyone? Anthony here, and welcome back to another video here on Let's Talk Resident Evil. And in today's video, we will be discussing Resident Evil 5. Yes, Resident Evil 5 Remake is in talks around the internet with Resident Evil fans alike, wondering if it's going to be the next Resident Evil remake that Capcom is looking to do. Judging from the ending of Resident Evil 4 Remake, as well as the Separate Ways DLC, it pretty much is leading right into Resident Evil 5. That's exactly how the cutscenes are kind of leading those breadcrumbs into that next part of the story, following Albert Wesker being the ultimate villain with Ouroboros. So the last few days on the internet, thanks to a couple shitty websites, one of them in particular I usually don't like to talk about because they are trash, and we felt this way for years. As we say on, you know, Game Complainers, the podcast, all three of us collectively say you can't spell ignorance without IGN, right? And we're unfortunately sitting here today talking about an IGN article that has been making waves online. A lot of people have been making videos about it. A lot of big-time YouTubers are also making videos about it. So I said, you know what? I've been doing this for 14 years, and I've started this channel making Resident Evil 5 content on the DLC. So, you know, I kind of have to also give my two cents in here and also kind of react to their full video because I haven't seen this yet. I mean, I've seen this topic. I've seen their title of their video and article saying that, you know, this Resident Evil 5 can't be remade. It can't be done unless there's drastic changes to it. So I have their video pulled up. I usually don't like to promote their trash content or article writing. But I'm going to sit here and watch it with you guys, and then I'm going to kind of react and give my two cents on this topic of Resident Evil 5 Remake not being able to be made in today's world of 2024. So let's jump into this video and see what the hell these idiots had to say.
With Resident Evil 4's release last year, Capcom's project to remake the glory years of its survival horror series is complete. But as the game's post-credit scene suggests, the remakes aren't over. And so the big question is, where next? The obvious answer is a remake of Resident Evil 5. But on the game's 15th anniversary, it's clear that moving forward chronologically will take Capcom's remakes into the series' weakest era, an era of gameplay and narrative decisions best left in the past. Resident Evil 5 simply can't be remade. At least not to the standards of Capcom's best work. And so the answer is not to remake,
I disagree,
but to rewrite.
I mean, look, I just want to say real quick that I don't necessarily think it has to be, you know, a game that can't be remade because of a, you know, mechanic standpoint. Because at the end of the day, you know, there's a bunch of things that can be adjusted in this remake of Resident Evil 5 that can be more in line with Resident Evil 4 Remake. For example, you actually add the attaché case back. You don't have to have a forced co-op on there either. You could probably choose whether or not you want to have a partner or not, or they can make it to where if it is co-op, your partner won't have individual health, individual ammo. It will be more like how Luis was to Leon in Resident Evil 4, where he can just, you know, kind of take damage, do his own thing, and you're just solely focused on yourself. I don't see why that is an issue, but I know where he's heading with this video already.
Resident Evil is a survival horror series. Not that you'd know that playing Resident Evil 5.
Oh.
Sure, it features a constant flow of horrific imagery, but Resident Evil 5 is an action game through and through. That's evident in its cover shooter mechanics, vehicle chases with on-rails turret sequences, and the constant rattle of assault rifles.
Yes, I can agree there that Resident Evil 5 tuned up the action tenfold, yes. Again, something that can also be changed in a remake.
In its visual design evokes the sandy shades of modern military games that experienced mass popularity in the late 2000s. It all speaks to a series that had lost its way. Rather than reflect on the tenets that were the foundation of its experience, Resident Evil 5 looked to the contemporary gaming zeitgeist in an attempt to find a new lease of life. The result is an unholy hybrid of Resident Evil, Gears of War, and Call of Duty. It's as ugly and unwieldy as it sounds.
I mean, it's Resident Evil 5 is a fun game. It's a fun action co-op game. It's not horror. The story isn't the best I've ever seen in Resident Evil, but it's a fun co-op game, and I played the shit out of it, and I know many of you played the shit out of it, And IGN gave it a 9 out of 10 back in the day, so...
This design appears to not just be a misguided attempt to follow Western successes, but also a misreading of its predecessor. With Resident Evil 4, director Shinji Mikami deftly reinvented the series through the use of a new over-the-shoulder camera angle. The perspective allowed for a more kinetic, action-heavy game. Despite this, Mikami never lost sight of the terror at the core of Resident Evil. Through the use of enemies that were strategically placed to provide undulating waves of tension and fear, and the inclusion of Ashley as your vulnerable charge, combat encounters were focused on surviving overwhelming horrors rather than dominating foes. Resident Evil 5, meanwhile, presents its enemies as waves to be gunned down with increasingly powerful weaponry. Their purpose is cannon fodder, a wall of meat to slow your progress through levels. And those levels are not locations to be explored. Instead, they are largely funnels that push you from entrance to exit. Resident Evil 4 may have replaced the series' traditional continuous structure with discrete levels in an attempt to move away from the backtracking-heavy design of previous games, but it preserved the spirit of locations like the Raccoon City Police Station. The village, Salazar's castle, and the island feature interlocking, explorable pathways that solidify these locations as authentic spaces rather than obstacle courses. Resident Evil 5 has no interest in this, with the majority of its stages being little more than corridors peppered with dead ends to hide treasures in.
Okay, so this is just like, that's up to opinion, I guess. It depends. I think I really enjoy the Spencer Mansion in Lost in Nightmares, the other Spencer Mansion. I actually do enjoy the last part of the compound before leading up to, the Wesker fight and Cassella fight. I actually do enjoy those areas of Resident Evil 5. Now, while I don't think that there's, I would even say even the Resident Evil 4, the original locations aren't, I guess they're memorable, but they're not anywhere close to as memorable as the police station, as the original Raccoon City. I mean, not even close, in my opinion. And I guess I could say the same for 4 and 5, the originals, where, yeah, some locations are cool. I do like the village in Resident Evil. I love the castle. That's my favorite section of Resident Evil 4. But, like, you cannot talk about those games in as far as stuff being memorable like how you can in the original trilogy. Sorry, that's not, we don't do that here. But, you know, it's all a matter of opinion, I know. But at least on this channel, I've stressed that the original trilogy is my favorite. And I don't think that, you know, 4, 5, and 6 as the second part of an extension of that trilogy has any memorable, you know, areas like that. But
their lack of authenticity means no one will ever mention the Kijuju Autonomous Zone in the same breath as the Spencer Mansion.
Yeah, so he kind of just said what I just mentioned. However, you just mentioned Resident Evil 4 areas in the same breath as Resident Evil 3 with the RPD station? No. No.
All this is to say that a faithful remake of Resident Evil 5 would break Capcom's 7-year streak of brilliant survival horror games. It's telling that the series reset point...
I would argue that Village was not incredible. Village was an action-packed game that lost its way with the writing. So if you're going to talk about a streak being broken, it's already been broken, buddy. It doesn't mean they're still not making great remakes. It doesn't mean they didn't make Resident Evil 4 remake after Village and it was a complete success, because it was. But you gotta check what you're playing, buddy.
Resident Evil 7 was a reinvention of the very first game, a haunted house that grew ever larger as you unlocked new rooms by solving its puzzles.
Yes.
Clever reinventions of this base conceit is the key to Resident Evil's success, be that dropping an unstoppable force into the house's corridors, such as Resident Evil 2's Mr. X, or expanding the scope of the house. Resident Evil Village's titular location is effectively a giant manor. Its corridors are streets, and its rooms are houses. Resident Evil 5's stage-driven structure is simply inferior to this design. A modern recreation of it would only further highlight its flaws, especially coming in such close proximity to masterclasses like the remake of Resident Evil 2.
Yeah, but these are all things that can be adjusted and changed as far as location, memorable locations. I mean, these are all things that can be redone in a remake. I really don't understand, you know, what this angle is, but I guess we're about to find out.
Remakes can, of course, completely redefine the structure of their source material. Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, for example, is recognisably an updated version of the classic RPG, but its world design and gameplay mechanics are a world apart from the 1997 original, and so you could argue that Resident Evil 5 is actually the Resident Evil most in need of a remake. A whole new environmental structure and scenario design that reins in the action and dials up the horror would bring it in line with Capcom's other remakes. But all of this doesn't account for Resident Evil 5's most notorious problem: racism. Set in a fictional West African country, Resident Evil 5's primary antagonists are black people. Yes, it's technically the Ouroboros virus that protagonist Chris Redfield is fighting, but the parasite's host is depicted as a nation of mobs and primitives who are violent even before their infection. Intentionally or not, Resident Evil 5 positions Africa as the Dark Continent, an uncivilized world harbouring a diseased population that needs gunning down via Western intervention in the name of global security. This insensitive place. Treatment of people of color was hotly debated even as early as Resident Evil 5's debut
trailer. Kajuju is fictional.
Writers such as Ngai Kroll and Stephen Totilo pointing out the game's uncomfortable post-colonial imagery. The arguments and think pieces continued well into the game's release window, with IGN's own former editor-in-chief Hilary Goldstein also wrestled with the subject. But that was 2009, a time when race was apparently a debate rather than a reality. In the 2020s, in a post-Black Lives Matter world, there is only one acceptable response to a white man shooting waves of Africans for an entire video game. No.
Okay, that's it for this video. I'm not watching this trash anymore. So, basically, IGN is saying that Resident Evil 5 is racist. It can't be done today at all. And we can't do this in today. You're pretty much comparing a video game to... And it's funny, this is coming from a British guy as well, which doesn't make any sense. But here we go. You're comparing a video game to real life political issues, because, of course, everybody has to have, you know, everybody has to make it political nowadays, especially, you know, IGN being a bunch of momos writing these articles. And this is just Resident Evil 5 is not racist. It's just not. And the fact that I even have to sit here on this channel and say these words and have this discussion, we don't talk about these topics on the channel. We're here as an escape to discuss a franchise that's turning 28 years old this month. That's what this channel's for. So I'm not going to sit here and I'm not going to scream and yell, but I will say this. This guy's fucking wrong. And IGN, they can suck every inch of my dick, okay? Because this is bullshit. The fact that we have to sit here and have this conversation doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Resident Evil 5 focuses on Ouroboros. The progenitor virus, the origins of the progenitor virus, was found in Africa. Oh, I'm sorry. Nobody knows the story. Nobody takes a second to figure out how, you know, this game connects with the origins of the story and how all of these early adapters of getting into Umbrella, finding the virus, they found it from Africa. That's where the origin stemmed. What is Resident Evil 5's big thing of going back to the beginning, right? They have the history of Resident Evil between the loading screens. Chris Redfield, Jill Valentine, Wesker, they're all back. It was almost like a callback to the characters, bringing them back and fighting their ultimate villain, which started in the first game. It was telling you the history. It was telling you the story. It was building up to this Wesker fight, this final Wesker fight. Now, I agree, they probably shouldn't have killed off Wesker because I think he is a great villain and they probably could have done more with him. So there's not everything writing-wise I can defend for Resident Evil 5. It's not the strongest story. It doesn't have the strongest villain characters. But It's a buildup. It's showing you where the origin of the virus is, where Wesker currently has this Ouroboros, you know, following him, trailing him in Africa. There's a BSAA Africa division. You also have Sheva there along with Chris. And I understand, you know, oh, well, they added Sheva and they added, you know, some different colored zombies in there to, you know, kind of turn from the backlash back in the day, because that was the big thing of like, oh, well, they added Sheva, they added some light skin zombies, you know, But, and I know they're not zombies, they're, you know, Ouroboros, right? But it's like, it's not racist. It's just not. It's literally like, this isn't like every single Resident Evil game is doing this. You know what I mean? And there's a story here. It's not like Chris is just going into the village and just killing people. You know what I mean? It's literally a counter-terrorist unit against threats like this throughout the world. And there is an African division as well. And Doug and all his team members are leading it. Nobody talks about the characters. Nobody talks about the specifics. Everybody has to make this stuff political nowadays. And it pisses me off. And this has nothing to do with cops. Like, it has nothing to do with it. I know that's an issue. I recognize that. I recognize that there, like, it is an issue over here in America. But this is a fucking video game. This isn't, like, trying to stress some kind of, like, you know, political agenda, or Capcom doesn't have this, like, massive plan to show this hate through a game. It's a fucking video game. The fact that I have to sit here and say these words and make this video is honestly fucking ridiculous. And the fact that it's coming from just this random article, this random British dude, that is just sitting here saying, you know, oh, it can't be made in this kind of world. It's like, fuck you, buddy. Like, actually, fuck you. Nobody screamed and yelled at Resident Evil 4 when Leon is going into a Spanish village killing a bunch of Spaniards. Nobody said anything about that. And guess what? It's part of the story. It's where Sadler was beginning his experiments, right? Was beginning the research of the Las Plagas parasite. It was in Spain. Luis was a Spanish researcher. He was also in that, you know, in that bubble researching the Las Plagas parasite. And that's where it was. That's where it took place. Nobody complained in Resident Evil 6 when everyone was in China killing Chinese zombies. Nobody complained. So here we are with Resident Evil 5, and it's like, oh, that can't be done. Oh, this can't be done. It's like, okay, even if you want to use your hate for the game, that's one thing with the, you know, you don't like the action, you don't like the story. I understand that. But to flat out call Resident Evil 5 or Capcom racist for doing so, for making a game take place in this fictional part of Africa called Kajuju, which doesn't exist, it's a fucking video game. Fair and simple. It's a fucking video game. And it's part of, again, it goes back to the origins of the progenitor virus, which is why we got up to the point of the T virus, the G virus, so on and so forth, all the way into 2009 in the timeline when Ouroboros was the main thing. This is just like, you really can't spell ignorance without IGN. Fuck this guy. Fuck anybody that agrees with this, because again, all of this is for negative clout. Everybody has to be negative because that's what gets clicks, that's what gets views, and you know that them releasing this and disabling comments was them trying to avoid said, you know, backlash, because they just know that they're going to just put it up and, you know, run and hide. And I understand there's comments on the YouTube video still. I understand there's a bunch of articles, you know, kind of retweeting it or repurposing it. But the fact that we even have to have this conversation about video games is fucking ridiculous. And people need to grow the fuck up and get over themselves, to be honest with you, because this is just going to be a blaring conversation that's going to keep happening because people like the clout and people like to compare these video games to these real life things that are going on. And I understand that those things go on. I'm not denying that things in America are fucked up. And also other parts of the world are fucked up. Like, I get it. But it has nothing to do with Wesker taking over the world with Ouroboros in Resident Evil 5. I'm sorry, but it has nothing to do with that. It's a fucking video game. And it's just a remake that can still exist, continuing Resident Evil 4, without drastic changes to the setting. I'm sorry, but it's not necessary at all. And even if they were to say, well, you know, we might have to change it because they don't want to get backlash, well, then I think that would be fucking stupid. Because why censor yourself? Why bend the knee to these fucking idiots online that are so fucking sensitive. IGN gave the game a 9 out of 10. Completely contradicts what this guy said in the video. And I understand it's not the same gentleman that reviewed it back in the day. But, like, this is simply just for the clout, for the negative clout. That's all it is. Because the minute we start agreeing with these idiots is the minute that they think it's okay to continue making videos like this. And it's just, it's completely, I'm losing brain cells just thinking about it. This is so dumb. Resident Evil 5 Remake can still work today. I just don't see why everybody has to make it a race or political thing every time a game comes out or every time something happens. I'm sorry, but it's just ridiculous. It's Capcom does not have, it's not like, does every single game in the franchise take place in Africa? No. This is a game that is takes place in Africa because of the story. The story. We literally have Wesker, who captures Jill after the events of Lost and Nightmare. She falls out the fucking window. Where does Wesker end up taking his fucking research and data and everything? Kijuju. Where does he take Jill? Where she's captured, she's in the little bird outfit and is completely brainwashed? Kijuju. Where's Irving? Where's Cassella? All in Kijuju, right? That's where the game takes place. It's not just there to be racist. It's not. So that's the reality of it. It's just, it's so stupid. Nobody thinks of the story. Nobody thinks of the characters. They just think outrage. And the fact that there's people on Twitter, on social media, defending and agreeing with this, again, you deserve to just not write articles ever again and to be fucking just banned off the internet because you're just spewing this garbage, this absolute garbage. And it's just, it's so ridiculous. I still like Resident Evil 5. I'm allowed to like Resident Evil 5. There's flaws with Resident Evil 5, story-wise, pacing-wise, and it's a full-on action game. I understand that. But you can like Resident Evil 5 in 2024. You are allowed to like Resident Evil 5 in 2024, and it's okay to fucking talk about it. We can't like, oh, we gotta tiptoe around the subject because it's gonna make people mad. Fuck you. Again, fuck you. And fuck IGN for this shitty video, because all it takes is this video to spin around the internet, and now you have top YouTubers, top streamers talking about it. Resident Evil fans are talking about it, and I'm among those fans. Fuck you, IGN, seriously. And, you know, again, this video on YouTube might get banned. I might get censored myself just for speaking out on my opinion. I'm not saying anything bad, but because we're in this, like, you know, this censorship era of things, it's really unsettling. And the fact that people can't express their opinion is really unsettling. And that is thanks to all the social medias that are monopolized. That is thanks to all of, you know, people making shitty videos and articles like this. This is just a disgrace. And I think this guy who not only wrote the video, I don't know if this guy wrote it or IGN themselves, they're a mistake, and they should not be around anymore, but they're still going to be because they still get sent all the games. Don't, you know, nobody's going to talk about when IGN got paid off to make good reviews, right? Or to write these positive things about games because they're getting paid from developers. Let's not forget that that was a part of their history, right? These are the people that were given credit. These are the people that were saying, yeah, you know, we agree with this. No. Let's not give them any, even me doing this video is giving them clout because you just watched the video through my video. And I don't like to do that typically, but I had to give context as to why I'm sitting here talking about this in the way that I'm talking about it. It's just, it doesn't make any fucking sense. So Resident Evil 5 Remake should maintain its setting. Resident Evil 5, when it came out, did have problems. It was too much action, for sure. The script and some of the characters, like the villains of Cassella and Irving, I wasn't really happy about. And the game really was more unplayable when you didn't have a co-op partner there. Because Sheva had her own health bar, had her own ammo, and she would waste your ammo if you wanted her to hold on to certain things and vice versa. And she was just there as like a storage box, basically. And I think they can fix that with this. Like I said, make Luis be that example, right? How Luis was in Resident Evil 4, he could take damage. He has kind of like infinite ammo. And they can kind of build that in if you're playing it by yourself, where you just have to focus on yourself. You can get an attaché case. There can be an actual merchant there this time, and they can adjust that and make those things work. So there's certain things in Resident Evil 5 that I agree do need changing, and I think will be adjusted perfectly from what we got with Resident Evil 4 Remake. Add the side missions from a merchant, right? It doesn't have to be the merchant from Resident Evil 4, but whoever takes, you know, charge of the shop, make it to where we have side missions. You can make the environments more memorable. I actually really enjoyed the marshlands in Resident Evil 5. You know what I mean? And again, the lab section at the end of Resident Evil 5, I actually thought was pretty damn good. I don't think that everything this guy was shitting on in this video was also very necessary. I think he was using the one topic of the racism as like his, you know, this is why it's not good, so let me go on here. And, you know, skimming through the rest of the video, it looks like he talks about Resident Evil 6 and everything else, and we're just not going to sit here and watch the rest of that video. Everything he said in that first 5 minutes, I was like, that's it. I don't have to watch anything else of this crap anymore. But, yeah, essentially, you know, people are going to agree with this, which just doesn't make sense to me. Because, again, if you're a fan of Resident Evil, if you're a real fan of this franchise, you know why they did the things that they did in this game. And it's not because Capcom has it out for a certain group of people. I'm sorry, but they just don't. They have a story to tell, and Kijuju, this fictional place in Africa, is where they decided to tell the story. And it's not like they were just there for the sole purpose of just killing everybody in a village. They had an actual story. But everybody has to make everything political nowadays, and it pisses me the fuck off. I never knew I'd have to make this video here on this channel, but thankfully, anybody else that disagrees with me just turned off this video by now, and that's it, you know what I mean? But let me know what you think of this, you know, article, of this video. What do you think of Resident Evil 5 Remake? You know, do you want to see it? Do you not want to see it because of these reasons? We can agree to disagree in the comments, but I'm just saying that flat out, I think people have to check themselves and really think about how dumb some of this shit sounds coming out of their mouths. So that's my opinion on Resident Evil 5. I still want to see it remade, and I'm allowed to like Resident Evil 5 in 2024. So that's it. So smash that like button, subscribe if you're new or if you have a brain, and leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think of Resident Evil 5 Remake, and would you like to see it? Because there's a lot of great improvements that can come from it. So, let's see. But yeah, that's it for this video, guys. Take care, and I'll catch you in the next one.